a music hall. There are thousands across the country just like this one. A gathering place for music, dancing, friends, and fun. In a few hours, this space will come alive with excited fans ready to see their favorite band. But before the doors open, there's a lot to be done in more ways than you can imagine. Sure, the bar needs to be stocked, a sound check will be held, but what about the less obvious preparations? The ones that are happening every day in public places of assembly, but that we never really seem to take notice of. The ones that could mean the difference between life and death. Every day and night, people congregate in buildings to carry out life's businesses and pleasures. But threats to our safety are around every corner. It's men and women like this who help keep those threats at bay. Captain Nibs, how are we looking?
Everything's looking up to code so far.
So what's that mean? What's so dangerous about a place like this?
Well, in the fire service, this building would be considered an assembly. Empty, it's just a building. When you start adding in flashing lights, bumping music, and a lot of people, things can get bad pretty fast. Of course, we always have to pay attention to building occupancy capacity, but that's only part of the danger. Consequences can be devastating. Have you ever heard of the Rhythm Club fire?
What's the Rhythm Club?
To many, it's known as the Forgotten Fire. The past teaches us many things. April 23rd, 1940. It was supposed to be a night of fun. On that night, members of the Black community gathered for a barn dance at the Natchez Rhythm Club. A special band was in town. The place was draped in Spanish moss that gave it that upscale feel. The place was packed. To keep folks from sneaking in, the building's windows and back door were boarded shut or chained. It was a party, a celebration, but everything took a turn around an hour before midnight. There was a fire. That alone was bad enough, but the decorative moss made it so much worse. The moss was flammable and covered with a petroleum treatment called flit, which was used to prevent bugs. It not only fed the fire, but the air became toxic. Everyone panicked. They rushed for the only way out, the one door they came in. The volunteer fire department was called, but by the time they arrived, it was too late. 209 people never returned home. So many young people. It devastated this community. In many ways, those deaths were in vain. Nothing changed to make things safer.
Nothing changed?
Not really, nothing substantial on the prevention side. The city invested in a full-time fire department, but it wasn't until 2 years later in Boston where there was a fire at a club called Coconut Grove where over 400 people died. Then life safety policies changed. Makes you wonder if they paid notice to Natchez, if the devastation in Boston would have ever even happened.
I can't believe I didn't know about this.
I didn't know about it, not until long after I was firefighter and fire marshal, but now I think about it every time I do one of these inspections. Oh, speaking of.
Right, you have to finish that.
By the way, this story is ingrained in the city's history. You should take a walk around and check it out for yourself.
Have you ever heard about the fire that happened way down in Natchez, Mississippi town? Have you ever heard about the fire that happened way down in Natchez, Mississippi town? I was standing there when the old building burned down to the ground.
And there it is.
Okay.
The Natchez Democrat was the local paper at the time, and they were the first to report it. And then it went across the wire, AP wire, and New York Times picked it up, a paper in Amsterdam, mm-hmm. and a couple other international, national papers picked up the story as well.
And that's how it
And that's spread. How it fed across the country, across the world.
Wow.
I also have them here in, we have through the years copied the articles out of the paper to make it easier for researchers to come in. I have lived here 18 years and probably not till after about 10 years of living here did I ever know anything about this fire. You know, we have a lot of tourists here in Natchez for all of its history.
Okay.
And I think because we have all the different trail markers and we have a monument on the bluff for the Rhythm Club fire. It's a beautiful little monument, and the bluff is a beautiful place.
There have been similar fires over the years with similarly tragic consequences. There was Coconut Grove 2 years later, of course, but real change in fire codes didn't take up speed until then. The Beverly Hills Supper Club fire, 1977, another dance hall fire where 167 people died. In 2003, the Station nightclub fire, where we lost 100 people and hundreds more were scarred. In both of these cases, life safety codes were in place. They just weren't followed or enforced. Firefighters can only do so much once a disaster is unfolding. Natchez's improvements in their fire department helps in receiving calls and responding to them as fast as they can. But what if we design a world before an accident becomes a disaster? How do we learn from the past and plan for our future?
Warren, welcome to the University of New Haven's Fire Science Program.
Oh, wow, thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for being here. I understand you're interested in learning about what our students here are doing to make tomorrow safer.
I was just in Natchez, Mississippi, learning about the Rhythm Club fire. I'm just baffled that this tragedy isn't well known.
Natchez Rhythm Club fire is truly one of the forgotten fires in history, but not at the University of New Haven. Uh-huh. All of our students have studied it, and they don't want to repeat any of the mistakes made in previous fires. Mm-hmm. So that's something we truly focus on.
Yeah. You'd think that preventing boarding up windows or adding more exits, that's common sense, right?
You would think so. So it actually becomes a little more complicated than that. One of the things we look at is tenability. How long can you survive in a hostile environment like a fire? Hmm. So one thing is heat release rates. How quickly is temperature building? How long can you stay in a hostile environment filled with smoke? How long before you're actually experiencing choking smoke that might become debilitating or actually block your view of exit signs? And in terms of the decorations, the Spanish moss, which was treated with a petroleum distillate, that aided in the spread of the fire. That would actually today be considered an accelerant. And so we try and make sure by through testing that we eliminate hazardous decorations that could cause an event just like that.
There is just so much to learn here. So how do you teach your students about this?
So we have a machine called the cone calorimeter, if you'd like to see it.
Oh, I would love to.
It's right this way.
Okay, let's go.
Okay.
This is our cone calorimeter, and we use it to study the flammability of materials at a very small scale. A lot of the stuff that you fill your homes with now are very flammable. Our job is to study these materials and try and make them safer for the future. We're studying the flammability of materials because that buys us time. Time for people to get out of the house, time for firefighters to get in and get there before the fire grows out of control. Once we take this data after an experiment, we compile all the data into an Excel sheet and we do some further analysis and calculations, and we can actually eventually use some of this data to determine flashover in a building, time it takes to flash over, and the amount of energy that this fire can create that we have in a building at a larger scale. So with the Rhythm Club fire, they had that decorative moss with petroleum treatment called flit, which caused the fire to grow hot and fast, and not a lot of people were able to get out. By studying these materials today, we're able to use this information to decorate music halls safer for tomorrow.
I'm back. You redecorating?
Yeah, unfortunately, it wasn't up to code. The owner might not like it, but I'll sleep better tonight knowing that we did something to make this place safer.
Absolutely. So, what do you think? Are we ready? Wait.
Good job.
Safety is built into our everyday lives. It's hiding in plain sight. Safety features were born out of tragedies in the past thanks to creative minds planning for a better future. We've got code inspectors and fire marshals in our communities to make sure that the codes are followed. But it's also up to you and me. Together, we can honor those we've lost in the past by striving for a safer future. I've learned so much here today, and there's so much more to know. Thank you for keeping us safe so we can have an evening out like this. What do you think? Are we ready to open the doors?
I think so.
You heard him. Let's open the house.